to me, the journey and the freedom of expression of improvised music, personally, is the highest form of musical expression. When I was in Chick's Quartet with Bob Berg, John Patitucci, and myself, the second run of a tour we did, it's kind of an interesting choice that Chick made. We played maybe 5 weeks of concerts with no written material. It was completely improvised. Almost out of the old days when he had that band Circle, right? But obviously this had different instrumentation. But there were little ideas he would throw at us, like he had the Bartok Bagatelles, and we'd have like these little pieces of music that would maybe be just 6-bar phrase, and that would send us off into a 45-minute free-for-all. And those were the most satisfying moments out of the 5 years I played with Chick, because we got to these places that you could never plan. You could never, ever discuss that and walk onto the stage and have that happen. You could try it 1,000 times, I guarantee it won't happen. And those moments, those musical connections between the four minds and spirits, it's very hard to do that without having it be that open. I feel the best in a small group jazz format, trio or quartet, mostly improvised music. I'm a big jazzer, still to this day. And oddly enough, like harder rock and roll. Like for some reason, those are the two genres of music that I feel comfortable bringing my spirit to the table. You know, it's kind of an odd comparison, but, you know, going from something like, you know, playing with Alan Holdsworth, and then, you know, a couple months later, I'm in the studio with Rob Zombie. It's an odd duality, but in a weird way, I feel like just the way I feel time and what I can bring to the table, that's where I excel personally the most. Never enough study on your instrument, because it's a lifelong commitment. So you always want to acquire more knowledge or more ability, and that makes your vocabulary wider, it makes your palate more open, you know? I would believe that to be ultimately creative, to keep a stint of creativity in your career, it'd be hard to do that with the same knowledge, right? So it's kind of interesting, even on a quantum mechanic level, right? Like, we've gone a long way from the double slit experiment to the Higgs boson, right? So there's been knowledge and there's been creative thinking. Maybe there's this, or how do we come up to these decisions? So it's kind of a marriage, but I still do believe that the having a strong creative side is gonna override knowledge, you know, and maybe fear. Because if you lose the fear of judgment through lack of knowledge, then you can be truly creative.